NSAL stands for the National Survey of Sexual Attitudes and Lifestyles, and it's one of the largest surveys of sexual behaviour anywhere in the world. And they really provide a real framework for understanding people's sexual behaviour so that we can understand some of the determinants of poor sexual health and also good sexual health. We do quite a wide range of research, and we are understanding issues like sexual violence. We're looking at the impact of sex education and finding actually that people who cite school as their main source of sex education tend to have better sexual health outcomes in later life. We also have other members of our group who are more focused on specific groups of people who are perhaps more vulnerable, so particularly LGBTQ groups who, because they are part of a sexual minority, can have additional stigma and that can bring additional anxieties and other mental health problems in relation to their sexual identity. And those studies are all aimed at trying to identify ways to either impact on policy or on practice to improve conditions for those young people.
The unit has a real strong history of looking at LGBT health, and so I was kind of drawn to it because I was really interested in having that kind of expertise around me to kind of help me progress my work and develop my thinking. And because in my area, there has been some exploratory qualitative work done in England and Wales, but there hasn't been any done in Scotland, and I thought, oh my God, that's a real gap. And so that for me, being in Glasgow and allowing me to do that work within Scotland was so, so important. Glasgow is such a vibrant and dynamic city. It really allows for us to make partnerships with other organisations and really get out there and kind of be close to the LGBT plus community in Scotland.
I work as a practitioner, and a lot of why my project was informed was working with young people for like several years in like youth groups and community sexual health settings and delivering educational inputs in schools. And I kind of like wanted to make sure that whatever I spent my time in research doing, that it would like translate into something meaningful. And the unit definitely has a really big focus on that. And also there's quite a big focus on sexual health. So similarly, there's a lot of like expertise there.
We're at a time at the moment where the UK government is disinvesting in sexual health. And I think we may start to see the ramifications of that in the near future. So some of our work is really about just keeping the information there, because really without the data, it's very difficult to really persuade the policymakers that they do need to keep investing in this area of health.